Name this movie where you heard this dialogue.
I wish none of this had happened.
So do all who live to see such times, but that is not for them to decide. All we have to decide is what to do with the time that is given to us.
Monique in Sacramento listening to 1620 AM up there, and we've got a new FM translator. Hi, Monique.
Hi there. How are you?
We're doing really well. How are you guys doing out there?
Oh, we're hanging in there, right. Just like everybody else.
Yeah. So do you know the name of that movie?
I do. It's The Lord of the Rings, The Fellowship of the Ring.
It's exactly right. You've got The Fellowship of the Ring. Right? That's pretty good. And when do you know when that happened in the movie? What was the scene? What was going on?
I do. It's when Frodo and Gandalf are in the Mines of Moria, and they see Gollum creeping up, and Frodo says that maybe Bilbo should have killed him, and Gandalf says no, and tries to encourage Frodo. So that's where it is in the movie.
Okay, so how many times have you seen that movie?
More than I would like to admit.
And how many times have you read the books?
Not as many times as I would like to admit.
Okay, good for you. I remember the first time I read The Hobbit, I was in seventh grade. That was one of our assignments for seventh grade. So that would have been back in 1972 or so. It was really quite fascinating. But I didn't read the trilogy, The Lord of the Rings, until I was my first semester graduate school at Notre Dame in business. And I regretted that I picked it up because I couldn't put it down. I should have been studying other things.
Yes.
You know, once you pick it up.
I didn't read the books till I was an adult after I had actually seen the movie. And the movie is what inspired me to read the books. So I know I was a little late in getting to the books, but they were well worth it.
What do you like about that story?
I love that it's a hero's journey story. Mm-hmm. And I love all of the Catholic symbolism in it. Since Tolkien was a Catholic. And even though it's not shown in the movies as much, it is so much, very much shown in the books, with the Lembas bread representing the Eucharist that sustains Frodo and Sam and the fellowship in their journey, and Galadriel being a symbol of Our Lady, and she is there to help, and the ring representing evil and sin and its temptation over everyone who carries it. It's just a beautiful, beautiful story, and I know so many people who aren't Catholic don't know about the Catholic symbolism, or even those who are Catholic, so it's just lovely to have such a beautiful, wonderful story that's so rich in Catholic symbolism.
Yep, it's very much the human story, right? So the ring represents the reign of sin. Everybody's wounded by original sin. The most recent times I've read it and watched it, and I was telling this, I think, to you, Patrick, last week, there's two dates that actually jump off the pages to me, because most of it is framed in mythological language. Yep. But the date of March 25th, is mentioned when he drops the ring in the crack of doom. And I said, well, that's interesting.
Yes.
Everything's mythological except that date. Of course, March 25th is the Annunciation. That's the incarnation, which is the definitive end to the reign of sin because Christ takes on our human nature. The other date that's mentioned in it is October 24th, and that's where when Frodo volunteers to carry the ring to the crack of doom because nobody else wants to carry it. Aragorn doesn't want to carry it. The men don't want to carry it. The elves don't want to carry it. The dwarves don't want to carry it. And October 24th, when Tolkien was writing, was the feast of St. Raphael the Archangel. Of course, Raphael the Archangel is the one who leads Tobias on that journey in the Old Testament. And so he's a protector of journeyers. And I said, that's fascinating. Those two dates jump out.
It is. You are, I would say, an amateur expert, Father Rocky. You seem to have a deep knowledge of the Lord of the Rings trilogy.
I would say I'm a fan. Just
you're a super fan.
Well, I do like that. I certainly, for all the reasons we've been hearing, I find it fascinating. I'm always curious about those details, trying to connect the dots, link the whole things together. But certainly, it's a beautiful story. I like Sam. And the trade-off between Sam and Frodo, that their friendship lasts through it. Because even with your best friends, there will be times where you get upset and get angry. And you need to realize that the friendship is worth more than being right. You know, because our Lord Jesus Christ never gave the commandment, thou shalt be right. And we have to learn how to forgive and carry on and cherish that friendship we have with people. That's what's true. Beautiful between the relationship between Frodo and Sam. Wonderful. Well, I'm glad you called in.
I'm so glad I got through. Thank you so very much. It's such an honor to talk to both of you.
God
and I pray
you.
For everyone at Relevant
Thanks,
Radio very often.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
For more of The Patrick Madrid Show, visit relevantradio.com/Patrick.